Hello, my name is Harald Weber and I'm working as project manager for the German Engineering Association BDMA in the department Plastics and Rubber Machinery and also for the European Umbrella Association EuroMap. In this presentation, I'd like to give you an introduction how the manufacturers of plastics and rubber machines make use of OPC-UOA for exchanging data between their machines. I will start with our motivation why we deal with the exchange of data via standardized interfaces before I explain deeper our concept and structure of the OPC-UOA companion specifications for plastics and rubber machines. What was the situation in the past? We had more or less simple machines, but already with some automation. The necessary information between the machines was mainly done by simple interfaces like plugs with I/O signals. Over the time, the machines and also the automation became more and more complex, which has consequences for the required data exchange. This development is ongoing and will lead to a smart factory in which we need to have a digital representation of the machines. All this is subsumed over the term Industry 4.0. The networking of machines with increased data exchange leads to a change of concepts and business models, providing several benefits for the users. These benefits are mainly increasing efficiency and quality. I'd like to illustrate this on a simple example regarding remote control and monitoring of machines. Monitoring of one machine can be easily done by a single operator. This still works with a limited number of machines. When the number of machines increases, monitoring of all machines becomes laboriously and problems might be recognized only after a longer time. When the machines are connected to a central computer, the monitoring becomes much easier and problems are recognized much faster. This is shown here in the comparison between the old situation and the new situation. But what happens when the machines come from different manufacturers? The connection to a central computer needs standardized interfaces. Of course, it is possible that each manufacturer creates own interfaces which are not compatible with interfaces of others. But this is not the business model of plastics and rubber machinery producers. The users of the machines want to combine the machines from different manufacturers in their factory. Here, standardized interfaces reduce the efforts both on the manufacturer side and the integrator and plant operator side. The idea of standardized interfaces is not new. For many years, the European Association of Plastics and Rubber Machinery, EuroMap, has provided recommendations for electrical interfaces between several machines. These are based on hardware plugs with specified signals for the several pins. They are very reliable interfaces, which are also used for safety signals. But transferring only one signal over one pin, the interfaces are inflexible and limited in their functionality. Also, for the communication with central computers, the so-called manufacturing execution systems, MES, EuroMap provides some specifications. In the past, there has been a text file-based protocol which is not compatible to the current technology. This is why a group of manufacturers producing one kind of plastics processing machines, namely the injection molding machines, started to create a new interface in 2014. They decided to use OPC-UOA as a basis. The main reason for the choice has been that OPC-UOA is manufacturer independent and offers a modular, object-oriented structure with many predefined functionalities. It just needs an IP-based network independent from the lower communication layer. But what is most important, OPC-UOA offers the mechanism of so-called companion specifications. As OPC-UOA itself is just a communication technology, the companion specifications define in information models which data is exchanged via the interface. And since 2014, several working groups have been established within EuroMap, also with the support of the OPC Foundation. For this, EuroMap signed a memorandum of understanding with the OPC Foundation. An overview on our activities can be found on our website euromap.org. In the working groups, we have to distinguish between different use cases. On the one hand, we have the vertical communication between machines and central computers, MES. The main functionalities here are the monitoring of the machine and the processes, management of jobs, and also the management of programs, setting data for the machines for the production of different products. Current projects are EuroMap 77 for injection molding machines and EuroMap 84 for extruders. For blow molding machines, a new group will start working in December this year. In the horizontal communication, the different components of process lines talk to each other. Sending and receiving data on machine status, process values, release signals, and so on, gives the possibility to increase efficiency and quality of the whole production line. Downstream equipment can react on input coming from upstream equipment. And this again, independent from the manufacturer. Current projects for the horizontal communication are EuroMap 79 for the interaction of injection molding machines and robots, and EuroMap 82, which will have several parts for different peripheral devices around an injection molding machine. For example, temperature control devices or dosing systems. How does the work in the working groups look like? We have the two aspects, the what and the how. Independent from the use communication technology, the functionality of an interface must be defined. This includes relevant properties of the described devices, process parameters, remote control functions, and also notifications. When this is fixed, the modeling in OPC UA starts. There, object types, data types, methods, and events are created. The result of the work is a structured model for the specific use case. By providing a semantic description, this is not only a data model, but an information model. When a companion specification is published, it consists of several elements. The first thing is always a clear definition of the concerned machine and the use case. The object types, methods, and events are formally described in standardized tables. These are accompanied by graphical overviews and verbal descriptions, explaining the meaning of the described parameters. As machine-readable component for each companion specification, an XML file with a model is provided. This can be used by developers for the creation of OPC UA servers and clients. EuroMap 77 is the most advanced project. As mentioned, the development started in 2014. In September 2017, we have released the second release candidate, which is available for free on our website. EuroMap 77 is developed totally by over 20 companies. Most of the work is done by the manufacturers of injection molding machines, where all major European companies are represented. But of course, also manufacturers of MES were involved, and also manufacturers of automation systems. All these companies were absolutely pulling together to create a comprehensive standard independent from one single manufacturer. And that this works has been demonstrated at the world-leading exhibition on plastics and rubber, the K-Show in October 2016. A network over the different halls with machines from different manufacturers was set up, and an OPC UA client was able to receive selected values from the running machines. What is the functionality included in EuroMap 77? First, we have some basic information about the injection molding machines. These are, for example, the name of the manufacturer, the model, but also the current configuration, like which molds and injection units are installed. The next information block is the current status of the machine. Is the machine in manual mode or automatic mode? Which operators are currently logged in? What is the reason for a current standstill? After this more or less static information, there's a block for the complete management of jobs. A job may be produce 10,000 mobile phone cases. EuroMap 77 includes basic information on the current and possible following jobs, name, description of the part, used molds and material, and so on, as well as a job status, if the machine is startup phase or already producing parts, how many good, how many bad parts have been produced. As dynamical data, the current process parameters are transferred. The relevant process parameters like times, temperatures, pressures are listed and described in the specification. This common understanding is absolutely necessary for comprehensive monitoring of these parameters independent from the specific manufacturer of the machine. Another functionality is the management of so-called production datasets. These are files containing the setting of a machine for the production of a specific product. EuroMap 77 provides functionalities to list the available production datasets as well as transferring them between the machine and the MES. As EuroMAP 77 is not the only specification for plastics and rubber machinery, a common structure became necessary. For this purpose, EuroMAP 83 was created. This includes requirements and type definitions that can be reused in the application-specific information models for different use cases. When looking at EuroMAP 77, most of the use types are now defined in EuroMAP 83. So the definition of job and dataset management had been defined in a general way so that it can be used for injection molding machines, but also for blow molding machines, extruders or other machines. As special type definitions, EuroMAP 77 then includes an injection unit type, because this is only relevant for injection molding machines. Within this type, all the components defined in EuroMAP 83 can be used, which is done here with the temperature zone type. In the development of EuroMAP companion specification, this means each working group has to check if necessary information blocks are already available in EuroMAP 83. In addition, if new blocks are modeled in a working group, a general modeling for possible reuse must be considered. This process is not limited to plastics and rubber machinery. Some information blocks are relevant for other branches and need to be defined on a higher level. VDMA, as representative of the complete machinery industry, is taking this task and develops the necessary process, also in close cooperation with the OPC Foundation. Nevertheless, even this overall structure is not finished yet. EuroMAP continues its work to give input based on the gathered experience. So the next steps in EuroMAP are, first of all, to finish EuroMAP 77, which is currently a release candidate which has to be tested and then published as release version. This will be done in the beginning of 2018. But as mentioned, EuroMAP 77 is the information model only for one machine. So we have to develop further companion specifications for other machines, like extruders, blow molding machines, and also peripheral devices. Some projects have already been started, but more will follow. Here, again, it's very important that the created models follow a homogeneous structure to ensure maximum compatibility. But also, time is a critical factor. The longer the standardization takes, companies will create individual solutions because they want to connect their machines. I'd like to finish with again mentioning our website, euromap.org, where information on our activities can be found and especially the current projects are listed. Thank you for your attention.